Welcome back, gamers, to another test server session. This time there's lots of things going on the test server, although the Halloween event is running on the live server. So what is new this week? As you can see on the left side, a new robot prototype has come to the test server. This one is called the Hellburner. Maybe you have heard of it. Pixonic announced this one maybe 2 months ago. This is a light robot that can explode when it has reached its end of life. So let's have a close look at it. This is what it's like. It's a light robot with a heavy and a light weapon slot. And yeah, the special ability of this bot is to explode and to damage, in that case, an enemy when you're close enough to it. Let's give me the stats. On level 8, this bot has 98,000 health points, can walk or run at a speed of 58 kilometers per hour, and yeah, it has the ability to explode after destruction. What this means, we will see in the fight later on. So let's go to the next topic. The glider, or as it's now called, hover, is back. This is the robot that has the ability to raise up. I've shown you this one some times before, but let's have a close look at it too. Yeah, looks pretty cool. It has one light and two medium weapon slots. And as I told you, can raise up to the sky. On level 8, this bot has 121,000 health points, can walk or run at a speed of 48 kilometers per hour, and yeah, can hover, as the name says. Then the next big thing is a new medium weapon. Here you have the, yeah, it's not shown its final design, but we can have a close look at it too. Here we are. This one is a medium weapon. It's a shotgun like the Thunder. It's called Storm. And yeah, let me give you the stats. This weapon has on level 8, or can do, 4,610 damage points per second at a range from 0 to 500 meters, like the Thunder. It can give a one shot per second. It has a capacity of 8 shots and needs to reload 10 seconds. But it can also be fired while reloading, like the Thunder 2. So it's just the Thunder in small, or in smaller. And what it can do, we will see in the fight later on. And the last thing concerning robots or weapons is the Boar. The Boar has got a new design. What this looks like, I can show you with the bots in my hangar. Here we are. This is the new Boar. The Boar before looked like an office printer, at least to me. It was like a big box, a big black box. Not really, yeah, fun. Well, it wasn't really funny to look at it, so yeah, now it has the design similar to the Schütze. It also has the same shape of the head and this little nose on, or this little bumper on the head. It really looks like the Schütze, but a little bigger. Yeah, this is all for now for bots and weapons. The map Dreadnought is also back, and I hope we can fight there immediately. So let's go to the line and setup and go to fight. Besides those two new bots, I have two lances in my lineup, both with the new medium shotgun, the Storm, One of them with the thunder on top, and the other one with an Ancel shield. And last but not least, I have a Fury of Zeus. As I know from my experience, the last time the hoverboard was on the test server, this is the most appropriate weapon to get down those bots. Especially when they raise up to the sky, they're an easy prey for the Zeus. Yeah, that's all for now. So let's go through the fight and see what the new weapons, what the new bots, and what the Dreadnought map is like now. Here we go. I think I'll take the hover first. As you can see, the map is much more detailed than it was the last time. The sand looks, yeah, pretty nice. The surrounding landscape also looks really nice. You have this, yeah, shimmer of a desert storm. Also really nice, but you also can see that there are lots of details missing. The outside of the spaceship is very detailed, but the inside and some of the fragments that are lying outside in the sand don't show much detail. And there's a rhino running towards us. I don't understand why my teammates didn't pick up the or didn't grab the beacon on our side of the field, our home beacon. Oh, there is a bot on the top. So let's use the ability to get up in the air and to shoot. This is on the one hand nice function, but on the other hand it's still impossible to push the ability button and the fire button at the same time. You can only raise or you can only shoot. You have to consider that when you take precision to fire. It's not possible to just sneak over the edge of a structure or something like that in order to fire then. No, you have to raise up much higher in order to reach the height needed to fire appropriately, to aim appropriately. As I told you, have a look inside. There is only a gray whatever. There's no structure inside. I think Pixonic decided to redesign the interior of the spaceship, so yeah. The outside looks pretty cool, very detailed, very nice. But the inside is just missing everything. It is only gray. And when you have a look at it, you don't know where one obstacle begins and where the other ends. You don't even know where to walk. So this is a little irritating. I think there is a wall. I can't see. Beacon is mine. Oh, there is a gap between those between two obstacles. Yeah, so let's see what the new medium shotgun, the Storm, can do. As there are lots of shielded bots inside, this may be the best choice. Here we go. As you can see, Storm doesn't do much damage, at least when you are not too close to the enemy. And when you are close to the enemy, it doesn't do any damage at all. It just, at least it looks like that. As you can see, it wasn't able at all to bring one of those bots down. Let's see if the combination with the thunder, the bigger brother, makes more sense. I think I can, when there is an edge, I can walk around. Yeah, combined with the thunder, the storm is better in use, but I think most of the damage I do come from the thunder, not from the storm, so yeah, I don't really think that the storm is a powerful weapon, at least at this state of development. So before the fight is over, let me show you the new light bot, the Hellburner. Yeah, it has pretty long legs, as you can see. And one tip, don't push the ability button. This ability button just forces the bot to die. This is the only thing this ability button does. You have 10 seconds, you run with at a higher speed. This gives you the chance to get close to the enemy in order to do the kamikaze damage. This bot is good for. So now is the appropriate time to do so, and I've died. Sorry for not being able to show you the damage this little Hellburner can do when you get to the enemy, but I can tell you it works, but it's very tricky. You have to push the ability button, in my opinion, in order to use the kamikaze mode, and you have to your timing has to be very good in order to use the full potential of the kamikaze mode. You have those 10 seconds where you can run at a higher speed. And then your little bot, yeah, bursts. And when you're not close enough to your enemy, to your chosen target, or you die before you reach your chosen target, this bot is just wasted. You know, this ability doesn't work properly, and you just die without doing any damage. So here's a little dog trying to kill me. teammates should concentrate on getting beacons, not on taking out enemies. Yeah, this is a loss. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. So, what's the resume of today's test server session? You have seen the two new bot prototypes. The little hell burner, which I think is not a good idea. Why should anybody or should anyone take a light bot in its lineup that doesn't isn't able to do much damage, and the only thing he's good for is to die and perhaps, you have to say perhaps, kill one enemy. Yeah, you can use this slot in your hangar more efficient when using a medium or a heavy bot and taking out 3, 4, or 5 enemies with one bot. So it doesn't make really sense to me. The hover bot, yeah, looks pretty cool. The nozzles on the back and the streams coming out and so on, looking really cool. But as I told you, it's not possible to raise up, to sneak over edges and fire, as you have to choose between the ability and the fire button with your right hand. At least when you play on a mobile device like a smartphone or a tablet, when you're using a shield where you can connect a gamepad, then this might be something else. But yeah, in this case, playing on a mobile device, it doesn't make any sense to use this bot. Especially when you raise up too high, you're just an easy prey for the Zeus Fury, which can take you out within 3 or 4 shots. Especially when the spot comes to the live server where the Zeus might have level 12 MK2, so the destruction is, yeah, deadly. The new board design, yeah, you can like it, you can't like it, or you can dislike it. Yeah, make your own mind of that. The shotgun, the medium shotgun, the Storm, in my opinion, doesn't work properly. It doesn't do enough damage. It's only working for me combined with the Thunder, where the Thunder makes the most damage, more damage than both of the medium shotguns I had on the Lance. So yeah, either Pixonic increases the damage or yeah, decreases the spread of the bullets, but this kind of development, this weapon, for at least for me, isn't useful at all. And the map, yeah, looks pretty cool from the outside. The inside, as you have seen, you can't see where there are edges, you can't see where there is a structure or not. It's only a gray, yeah, a gray something inside, but on the outside looks pretty cool. But it's another sniper map, which I'm not a friend of. Yeah, and that's it for today. So I hope you like this video. Please leave comments. Maybe you'd like to subscribe to my channel in order to keep informed. So, and if you like my video, we'll see you next time on the test server. And until then, happy hunting.